Hi students, class 9, chapter 8. Today we are going to see the chapter statistics. First of all, we want to know what is meant by statistics. We are collecting some data, we call it as a statistics. For example, how many children are in a school is the statistics, and how many newborn baby in particular years, and what is the rain in that particular season. These are the we collected as a data. That data is called as statistics. First of all, we want to know what is the data. The data is a collection of any information. Definition for data: data is a collection of any information is called a data. For example, in our classes, how many students are get sent in max subject, how many students are get below 50 in max. This data, these are the informations collected from the classroom, right? This is called a data. In this chapter, we are going to see what is the average of the data. That is the main theme here. Now we want to know what is the measures of central tendency. The measures of central tendency, we have three different methods. One is mean, and then another one is median, and then third one is mode. So the measures of central tendency means mean, median, mode. These are the measures of central tendency. Here all the term what we are going to learn is that is the average of the particular data, that is the central tendency. Simply we can say it is a mean or arithmetic mean. Here we have two types of data. One is a grouped data. Data is into two form. One is grouped, another one is ungrouped. So two types of data here we have. What is the difference between the ungrouped and the grouped data? Ungrouped means a particular students who are taking the marks in all the subject. For example, English, Tamil, Maths, Science and Social Science. This all the marks are called ungrouped data. And then grouped data means, and then in a classroom, all the students in a classroom, each student, what they have get in a max, what they have get in a science, and then social science, it will be tabled in a table form. Tabled, right? The first students have taken 20 marks, and then second students have taken 30 marks, and then fourth students have taken 50 marks. In a grouped form, or first 1 to 50 marks have taken 20 students, 50 to 70 marks have taken, that is 1 means that is 35 is the minimum pass mark, right? So 35 to 50 is 20 students, and 50 to 17 is 10 students, and 70 to 100 they have get 5 students. Mean this total number of students is the we call it is a frequency. So simply we want to say means ungrouped data. In a class, all the students have scored the max marks only we are entering, or science mark only we are entering up to that number 35, 36, 70, 74, 80, like this. This data is called ungrouped data. Particularly, all the students have taken only in a single subject, we enter like this mark, right? In a grouped data means 10 students have scored 35 to 50 or 60 to 70, like this. In this manner, we take this means it is a grouped data. Why we have splitted the grouped and ungrouped data means here we have the method to find the arithmetic mean of the ungrouped data is otherwise is called a raw data. Raw data means firstly what we have getting from the students, that is the raw data, and then grouped data means after the taking the raw data, we have make it in a tabular form, and then this particular students, 10 to 20 students are got that particular marks are like this. This is a grouped data. So the ungrouped data is also called a raw data. Here we have two method to find the arithmetic mean. Let's see the arithmetic mean of raw data and ungrouped data in the next video. Thank you, students.